A contentious day of testimony as cop killer Michael Astorga takes the stand in his own defense. At times, it turned into fiery exchanges between Astorga and the district attorney. Action 7 News reporter Ana Velasquez is live with those fireworks.
Well, Shelley, there is a lot riding on this. If the jury is convinced that Michael Astorga intentionally killed Deputy James McGrane, he may face the death penalty. So he continually and repeatedly told the jury that he's innocent.
Never in 6 years or over 6 years, ma'am, have I ever said anything about blasting a cop, killing a cop.
Michael Astorga maintained his innocence, and District Attorney Carrie Brandenburg quickly attacked. She created a list of liars, people Astorga said lied about him under oath.
And with respect to the courts, ma'am, a number of people have came in here and taken an oath, and that hasn't been the truth.
I am very aware of that, Mr. Astorga.
Thank you.
I'm very aware of that.
I appreciate that.
Astorga believes police have wanted him dead since Deputy McGrane's murder.
If my name were Levi Chavez, Bill Richardson, or anybody else, would
Mr.
I be in
Astorga,
these shoes?
I'd like to ask the questions, please.
Then more fireworks when he explained he didn't turn himself in because he was afraid police would kill him.
New Mexico is ranked number 2 in the country for police fatality shootings.
Brandenburg fired back.
Do you know in 2006 there weren't officer-involved shootings? So you're using what's happened in 2010 as a reason for thinking what you did in 2006, unless you are an incredible psychic. I don't know how that applies.
Now, Astorga also compared himself as a victim. He put himself in the same category as a victim as the McGrane family. That didn't sit very well with Mr. McGrane Sr. I'll have his reaction coming up for you tonight at 10. For now, reporting live from Santa Fe, I'm Ana Velasquez, KYT Action 7 News.
Closing arguments for this phase of the sentencing hearing could be as early as Friday.